quad and in the gymnasium. Mitch Marner and the Leafs were streaking. Speaking of streaking, David Pastrnak and the Bees extended their home point streak in a tight one over the Isles. And yep, you guessed it, the Great Eight made some more history Tuesday in the Windy City. All that and more, I'm LG Red, and On the Fly starts right now. Welcome to this edition of On the Fly. Well, it seems like only yesterday when we were chasing Alex Ovechkin around North America as he pursued 700. And here we are as the Great Eight joined the 800 Club with the Hattie in the Windy City, just one shy of one of the best to play the game in Gordie Howe. And the 37-year-old got there in style with a 29th hat trick against now 18 different franchises in a stretch where he registered 12 goals in 13 contests. And he continues just to make it look easy. But don't take my word for it. Why don't we show you in the highlight?
As a puck drop right off the faceoff, Connor Sherry coming in along the right side, and now they score, and it's Alex Ovechkin, 798, and he does it 24 seconds into the first period. Knocking on the door of history, it's 1-0 Washington. Alex Ovechkin, the 136th time he has opened the game with a goal. That breaks a tie with Jaromir Jagr on the all-time list. Ovechkin remains in the left circle. Second unit on for Washington. Milano tried to center. Here's Sherry. Low, and now the chance, he scores! The puck for Alex Ovechkin, tapped in at the left post. That is 799. He is one away from 800 with 11:46 to go in the first. It's 2-0 Washington.
When you think of these two goals that Ovechkin scored tonight, they're both pretty ugly, the way they've come off his stick. The first one was bouncing all over this place. This one, he kind of mishits it, and it still goes over the goal line, but it just goes to show how poor this coverage is by the Hawks right now.
65 seconds left in this first period. Turnaround chance, shot to score! And the Blackhawks are on the board. Center front, Ovechkin looking to open up. Wide open, empty net. And a goal! Trevor Van Riemsdyk, with the whole world paying attention to Alex Ovechkin on the left side. It's Van Riemsdyk into the empty net, and it's 3-1 Washington. Here's Domi trying to fight his way through. That quick shot, Rattstone, and the rebound, they score!
Tate's finally going.
And it's a 3-2 hockey game. Got it across, nice move, and Mrazek somehow made the save and a score! And it's 4-2 in favor of Washington.
Blackhawks starting, and now the turnover in front, and Mantha feeding it to Kuznetsov, and Mrazek diving, a shot, they score! And it's Alex Ovechkin, and it's 800 goals in the National Hockey League! The bench empties, Alex Ovechkin is the third player in National Hockey League history to score 800 goals. He does it here in Chicago, Illinois on the 13th of December, 2022. History here at the Madhouse on Madison. Alex Ovechkin, Gordie Howe, and Wayne Gretzky are now the only three skaters ever in National Hockey League history to score 800 goals.
That all started on a play from Anthony Mantha on the forecheck. They get the puck to the front of the net. Ovechkin finds the rebound. It comes right back to him. He shoots it in the empty net. And this is so surreal right now. This is absolutely incredible. He is just absolutely spectacular. He's not slowing down. 37 years old. That's his 20th goal of the season. How many times is that for 20 now? But most importantly, it's number 800.
And the horn sounds, and that'll do it. On a historical night, in the National Hockey League.
And what a night it was for Alex Ovechkin, who reached 800 in the win. More on that in a moment. On top of that, the Caps came away with their fifth win in a row, their longest streak of the season, and Chicago has now dropped four straight, scoring a mere four goals in that span. After the contest, Ovechkin spoke about reaching this historic milestone.
Special night. Going to have two goals right away. Feel the game and have a couple more chances to score. Third one a little bit early, but Mo and Kuzi do a great job finding me out there, and you know, it's a special moment. I'm very proud that it's over. You know, it's kind of like now we move on and we focus on the next one.
And there you have it. As we saw earlier, the Great Eight scored his 800th goal, becoming only the third player in NHL history to reach the milestone. He's now just one shy of tying Gordie Howe, who is the only other one standing in the way towards breaking Gretzky's record. Well, that was an Enterprise hat trick for Alex Ovechkin, as Ovi got things started early Tuesday with a goal just 24 seconds into the game. And then he added another one in the first period. He then, of course, capped off the hattie in style with career goal number 800 and the 7-3 win over the Black Hawks. Check out some of Ovi's accomplishments from Tuesday. He became the first player to score 800 goals with one franchise. His hat trick was the 29th of his career, giving him sole possession of the sixth most in NHL history. And it only took him 162 games to go from 700 to 800 goals, making him the fastest out of the three to do so. Now let's head to Toronto for the Ducks and the Maple Leafs.
This is an Engvall. In comes Pierre Engvall with it. Finds it back across. Score! Alex Kerfoot, and the Leafs have a 1-0 lead.
Big smiles for Alex Kerfoot. Now gets one on a very strong skate from Engvall. Another first goal scored by the Leafs.
Keeps ahead. In comes Marner. Holds. Back to score. Consecutive games as Tavares catches his 18th of the year. Lisa moves it and shoots. Oscar down on wide. Lisa throws a second, but bouncing puck. What a save by Samsonov as he takes that away in front from McTavish.
Off his skate, then down into the ground, trying to tap it through. How the goaltenders even track this bouncing puck? And you see Samsonov's head on the puck the whole time.
Matthews spins back. Timmons back across to Brody. Walks it and shoots. Scores!
Nice deep drive in by Matthews. Puts everyone back with their own time and space. And now Brody's got all kinds of space. And all that's off the skate of Benoit. So that will be Brody's goal.
Looks after Comtois. Max Comtois in. Shoots. And a glove save by Samsonov.
Big save by Samsonov on the breakaway. Needs someone back there. But Sandin, Liljegren, Marner all pushing up. And a breakaway into Samsonov denies the good glove save.
All feeds it back. Marner, a shot pass in. Rebound. Got a 9-game point streak.
Keeps getting down in the front of the net. That's where the action is.
Right.
And the worst team win.
Giordano feeds it back. Score! What a rocket for Kerfoot. He's got his second on 24 straight without scoring on a goaltender. He's got two tonight.
I want to hear about that talk. I want to hear about two in a game. It's amazing what confidence can do. Similar kind of play as his first goal. That's a nice release. And he has a bit of this old school wrist shot in his repertoire.
Spun around by Aston, races back at the point of Sandin. Engvall, and scores! Pierre Engvall fires it home, it's 6-0.
Well, this takes his time, and man, he's getting a lot of that. A little drag, he's flying in a hurry, he goes short side post back across the net. And Pierre Engvall continues his strong play. That's a little too top heavy.
Sandin fires, it's knocked down in front. Rebound, score! First goal since March of 2020.
Taking advantage of some of the injuries and some of the opportunity. A good release and finish for the extra point.
Zegras back to Henrique, right on goal. Samsonov jumps on that. Zegras takes a late bump there from Kemp. That draws a crowd. Schachter comes in late. A helmet comes flying out of there.
It's all smiles, all good for Toronto.
Toronto puts up a 7 spot to extend their point streak to 15 games, once shy of matching a franchise record. Now the Leafs defense continued to dominate on Tuesday with their third shutout win in the last four games. Ilya Samsonov now has back-to-back shutouts after stopping all 29 shots in the dub. Now let's hear from John Tavares on Marner's point streak.
It's pretty textbook 16, you know, he just ability to buy time and space, just open a lane, and I'm just trying to get good body position, and you know, he puts it right on my tape for me, you know, right on top of the crease. Doesn't get much easier than that. So you know, you play with a player like him, you work to get open, you know, he's gonna find you. So obviously he's been playing great, and great to see it continue.
Well, in the words of Blink-182, nobody likes you when you're 23. Well, it's hard not to like Mitch Marner right now after he extended his point streak to 23 games on Tuesday. And he's in some rare company, becoming just one of four players in the last 30 years to have a point streak of that length. Now we're off to Boston for the Isles and the Bruins.
The wrist shot tumbles off a couple of bodies, and Parisi knocks Omar down.
Yeah, Parisi, I believe, is getting the penalty here, Jack, for goaltender interference.
Elevates the pass. Pasternak scores! Goal number 20 goes through Varlamov.
Pasternak's looking for a redirect. He's not trying to score from there. He's trying to get the puck on net.
Sauced it over the line. DeBrusk, center, deflected, they score! That puck finds the back of the net, and the Bruins quickly up 2-0.
DeBrusk looking for Forsberg, never gets to him. Off the stick of the back checking Josh Bailey, changes direction dramatically. And you can see Varlamov, he's still looking for it. He never tracks that puck.
Throws the forehand, Dobson loads, breaks it, they score!
Bailey put himself in position, uses his skate, I believe, and now the Islanders are back in the game.
And Ruckus.
Very passionate.
Shot by Dobson off the post and in. What a shot for Noah Dobson. And he ties it with his second point of the night.
And then the referee felt the follow through of that hit right there by Greer, who sent him to the penalty box.
Jake DeBrusk breaking with Zacha. Pavel Zacha, your Dara Forward. He scores! A short-handed goal! The Bruins lead.
And this is the third quality scoring chance for the Bruins, shorthanded, all on one penalty kill. And what a finish by Derek Forbert.
And that one comes out to line for Aho. Back off the stick of Cizikas. He scores!
Casey Cizikas, and we're tied at three early in the third period.
A real good shift by the Islanders. He got in on the forecheck and started throwing the puck towards the net.
Drops to Marshawn and Pasternak. What a save by Varlamov!
It was a well-executed opportunity off the rush with one of the best goal scorers in the game, and David Pasternak.
A point apiece, and we'll go to overtime with still a chance to eke out the 2 points.
Peugeot has the game on his stick, and Omar stones him!
Tonight in Boston, for the first time this season, the Islanders are headed to a shootout. Barzal will take it wide and then slows. Barzal scores! On the backhand, he beats Olmark, elevated it up over the blocker.
Speeds in. Oh, he scores off the post!
It's his bread and butter. It's all about hands and pump fakes, and then where am I going? Shelf.
Must score. He misses! Boston 15-0-1 at home.
Pasta straight filth there in the shootout as the Bruins' home point streak lives on. Now, even though Boston got the lead early in the first, this game needed a shootout to determine the winner. David Pasternak scored the shootout winner, we just saw it there, and recorded an assist to extend his point streak to 6 games. Plus, Noah Dobson notched a goal and an assist for the Isles as he continues to lead New York City core in points. Linus Ullmark made 23 saves in Tuesday's shootout to give him 17 wins through his first 20 games this season, making him the fifth goaltender in NHL history to put up 17-plus wins through his first 20 games of the season. Now off to Jersey for the Stars and the Devils.
Here, nice spin move, Mercer, and he couldn't tuck it past the sprawling Wedgwood.
The thing I love about Scott Wedgwood in net is he's so competitive on plates in the low slot area. He has one of the best save percentages. He's top 10 in slot save percentage and low slot save percentage, and that would be low slot.
Out near the line, held in, and bounce score! Deflected in the slot, Ty Dellandrea.
And then the Stars re-rack themselves again. Nice keep at the blue line with a deflection from well out. Their netminder could never find it initially, and as it got deflected against the grain, could never locate it to keep in front. It was kind of a wild bounce up over top of the right shoulder.
You know that sequence where we said Suter made a save, that was one where they had a lot of chances.
Balls were shot, deflected, score! Miles Wood! Devils tie it up!
Oh, just mentioned bodies in front. Maybe get a redirection, that's exactly what transpired here. And good job again by Kevin Ball. Devils win the draw. That's key in the offensive zone. Goes to Ball, and Miles Wood does a terrific job of just getting a little piece of it and redirecting it past Wedgwood to tie the game up.
Holla had it in his skates, tried to play it. It's two on one. Look out. Here it comes to Glendinning in deep. Schmidt the save. He steps the rebound as well. Another otherworldly save from Akira Schmidt.
Watch this on the backhand, and then watch Schmidt stay focused and watch the push from the right to left in extension.
Not a lot of time left in the corner. 6 seconds to go. It's worked to Haskin and shot off the post. Rebound scored! Hits with a second to play in the second period.
They're able to control the draw even after the shot is blocked off the stick of Robertson. They go down deep. Their forecheck forges for the puck. They work it loose. Hints taking the eyes away from their netminder and then pokes it home.
Lays one back to the blue line. Hockenbaugh to the front. Big chance, and Schmidt makes a stick save on Glendinning.
Well, there's been a lot of difficult saves for Akira Schmidt. He gets a blocker on this back end, and Glendinning actually stayed pretty patient. Thought he had a lot of the net, but look at the effort, and no quit by Akira Schmidt.
Wall battle. Pops loose, and it's Brad. He's got options. Hamilton is shot. One time save. Wedgwood. Rebound towards the empty net. Will go in. Around the wall, and Fox is diving. Can't get it. It's Sagan. Moves it to Marchment. Has a look at the empty net, and he scores. Dallas gets a 4-1 victory over the Devils.
Took care of business. Used everybody, all four lines, and Wedgwood was an absolute rock back there for them at the Rock.
Well, the Devils dropped this one 4-1 and now lost three straight for the first time this season. Scott Wedgwood stopped 35 of 36 shots against his former Devils squad, as the Stars have now won five of their last six games against New Jersey. Well, coming up, Stamina time. Steven Stamkos extended his point streak to 14 games, and the Bolts told the Kraken, you can't touch this. On the Fly rolls on. Welcome back to On the Fly. Now let's get you out to a matchup of the top two teams in the West entering Tuesday, the Golden Knights and the Jets.
They win the draw. Morrissey drifting, shoots a riser, and they score!
Good job from Scheifele at just getting the puck to the net. Nice job sacrificing the body.
Smith against Morrissey. Little curl and drag into the middle. Miramanov looking. Shot, score! Daniil Miramanov with his first in the NHL to tie it.
And a perfect shot right under the blocker of Connor Hellebuck for his first in the NHL to tie this game at one.
Cut off by Martinez. Hague with a drive save. Hellebuck rebound, score! It's Mark Stone with 1.6 to go in the period.
Wheeler kind of falls, just get it back to the point, and then it's over a one-timer. Look at Stone all alone. Goes to the front of the net, gets rewarded with goals now back-to-back games.
Sandberg now shoots it right on goal. Rebound! They score! Barron has tied it at two!
Watts Sandberg stop, double pump, and he's got a knack to get pucks through. And a good job there on the second opportunity on the backhand, elevating.
Trying to feed that to Scheifele, blocked away by Stevenson. Stevenson trying to get another chance to the net, puts it in the crease, score! Mark Stone buries it, set up by Chandler Stevenson. That's two tonight for Stone, and a 3-2 Vegas lead.
Good pressure. pressure. Stevenson knocks it down once, then it gets by Schmidt. Look at the, how quick he gets away. Just gets it back to the front of the net. Stone does a great job getting up in the play.
Reaching for it, Stenlund behind the goal. Gagne shoved by Hay. Gagne back to the blue line. Brendan Dillon, wrist shot, tip, score! Sam Gagne, we're tied again. Gagne with his first in 19 games.
Gagne protects it, he keeps it on road, and then again, good. Good shot again from Brendan Dillon. He just floats this one into two tip layers, and it is Gagne. Look at that, intensity, as there's one tip, two tips, no chance for Aiden Hill as that floats up over the club.
Get an eye for that glove side on Hill, but the Winnipeg Jets get the puck back, and it's Connor. He's been kind of quiet. He'll find Shankly with a drive, and he scores! What a release from Mark Shankly, and it's 4-3 Winnipeg.
Shankly knows exactly what to do with that from range. Down on one knee, the one-timer as he rips a pellet.
Now Marchessault looking. Feeds it in front, he scores! Jonathan Marchessault beat Hellebuck between the pads. A power play goal to tie the game at four. As Marshall rolls out, he just puts this on the net. That finds itself through Hellebuck from a distance of a wrist shot.
Here, Manoff out top. Marchessault with a drive! Score! Jonathan Marchessault, his second of the period on the power play, and the Golden Knights lead 5-4.
What a shot by Marchessault. He gets all of this one. Perfect pass for Mira Manoff, will pick up his third point of the night.
Carlson with an open net to shoot at. Scores!
William Carlson, his first in seven games. It's an empty netter to give the Golden Knights a little more breathing room.
So in a game that saw a number of lead changes, lots of excitement, lots of action as Shankly scores a hat-trick goal with 1 second to go. And it's 6-5, too little too late, but 3 tonight for number 55.
Wow, what a thriller as the best teams in the West face off for the final time this season. And it was the Knights coming out with a season sweep. Jonathan Marchessault recorded his second multi-goal game this season. And with 2 seconds left, Mark Scheifele scored his sixth career hat trick. Well, the Golden Knights have been stellar all season, especially on the road. They improved to 13-2-1 for the second best road point percentage in the NHL this season. Meanwhile, they've scored 30 more on the road than they have at home to help with their plus 16 goal differential. Now let's get you out to Tampa for the Kraken and the Lightning.
We have rarely, if ever, seen Steven Stamkos hotter than he is right now. He enters this game with Seattle this evening carrying a 13-game point streak, the second longest of his career.
Holds back into the corner. Here's Hagel again. Settles it down. Drops it back. Where's the on the way? Scores! A shot from the point by Ian Cole. So it was tipped in front, and it's 1-0 Bolts.
Yep. Nikita Kucherov gets a piece of this one, I believe.
And it is now credited to Ian Cole. It goes all the way around for Kucherov. Sweeps that into the middle for Point. Picks it up and takes off. Here's Point dancing in. Chernak and shoots. Scores! Aaron Chernak takes the shot. And looks like the big guy's got his first goal of the season.
Ian Cole, his shot blocked, open ice. Jordan Eberle 2-on-1 with McCann. Eberle holds onto it. Here's McCann. He scores! Jared McCann, a perfect finish. 1:21 left in the first, and the Kraken are on the board.
And the Lightning are going to get power play.
Now they get a chance.
And here's Elaine stepping in. Is Perry trying to center? He scores!
I thought at first, boy, if he'd have speeded up, he'd have had a chance right on the rush. But he held on for a second and made a crafty little move. He's got such good hands. Vince Dunn looked as though he thought he was going to make a pass. He kind of swerved away.
Point on the middle. Here's Point. He's in. He scores. What a goal by Brayden Point.
Chalk one up. Another one up for the Ferrari section. That is going through the entire gearbox and not blinking an eye. Leaving people in your dust all the way along.
That will be shown for weeks. Cirelli off the boards, gets it to Sergachev. Sergachev with a shot, scores! Tipped in front of the shot from Sergachev, and the Lightning are rolling now. And it's going to be Ross Colton, 5-1.
boom there on Olofsson. And now in comes another member of the Kraken to have words with Colton. That is Donato right in front of you, Brian. And now Gord is tangled up with Pat Maroon. Look at this.
That's Yanni Gord, all right. He doesn't care. He used to play here. He doesn't play here anymore. And guess who's over there just jawing away?
Yeah.
Yanni Gord. I mean, his head's bobbing, and he's yelling down the other end.
Pass missed the mark, and now it's going to be picked up by Cirelli. Edmund feeds it down low. Little walk up, move by Stamkos. He scores! Steven Stamkos! 497 goals! And a 14-game point streak to boot.
Well, the Bolts now won 11 of their last 14 games after Tuesday's win as Braden Point found the back of the net, giving him 5 goals in his last 4 games. And Andrei Vasilevsky made 36 saves and now has a .930 save percentage over his last 10 starts. Wow, what a memorable night for these two in Lightning history as Nikita Kucherov becomes the fastest player to reach the 400 assist mark in his 590th game. Meanwhile, Steven Stamkos moves even closer to 500 goals as he continues his 14-game point streak. Up next, it's the Oilers and the Predators.
Here's Cody Glass. He fires it to the net. Score! It got through Campbell. Nashville gets a gift. Cody Glass puts it on net, and he gets his second of the year. Nashville off and running.
Bouchard has it redirected home by Hyman. This game is tied. Shot from the point. Hyman stationed in front of Lankinen, and it's 1-1. That's Hyman's 11th, and he's got goals in back-to-back games. Leon Draisaitl carries the puck and fires. Rebound. Hyman can't stuff it home, and then eventually nudges it over the goal line for his second of the period. 2-1 Edmonton.
And as you mentioned, Favreau diving in there, everybody all hands on deck trying to prevent it, but he stays in that grind for the puck and puts it home for a 2-1 lead.
McDavid around the boards, Draisaitl settled by Barry, thrown across, Nugent up to Draisaitl, one-timer score! And Leon Draisaitl continues to feast on the Predators. 5 seconds before the break, he's got his 20th of the year and his 19th goal in the last 10 against Nashville.
It's the trailer. Here comes Forsberg. One time a score!
Ryan Johansson cuts the lead in half.
And Johansson with a pumpernickel gets down on one knee, buries it. That's got to feel good for him.
Clear by McDavid, and now Draisaitl has a step on Bruce. Three shot score! Leon Draisaitl puts Edmonton right back up by 2. It's 4-2, and Draisaitl scorching against the Preds.
And he reverses it. Trennan now has some room. Trennan hits the trailer, and they score! Dante Favreau striking back. Nashville going top shelf in backdoor one-goal game.
Here's Draisaitl up the right wing. He's going to drop it back to McDavid. Skates into the Predators zone. He'll now cut to the middle. Scores! Connor McDavid! What a play! He gets to the middle of the ice and absolutely hammered that one in. Edmonton up 5-3.
Good pass now to Johansson. Johansson, an excellent pass. And then a great shot by Jankowski and a good save by Campbell. Puljujarvi ahead of the defense. McEwen coming back. They feed, and a great save. McDavid denied by Lankinen. Lankinen continues to keep his team within 2 for the moment.
Here's Hyman rushing for that hat trick. Whacks it toward the net and in! And there it is! On cue, Zach Hyman, his first career hat trick in the National Hockey League.
And boy, that's got to feel pretty good for Zach Hyman, who not too long ago couldn't put the puck in the net for 9 straight games. They're going in bundles now for him.
Man, and he earned that one as the Oilers dominate the Preds 6-3 and have now won 7 of their last 10 games. You just saw it there. Zach Hyman recorded his first career hat trick and tacked on an assist. Connor McDavid also followed suit with 4 points of his own and points in 10 straight for the second time this season. And how can we forget about that performance from McDavid's partner in crime, Leon Draisaitl? Yeah, you can certainly call him Nashville's Predator, if you will. How about you just take a look at the last 10 games against the Preds? Now he has a whopping 20 goals and 30 points against him during that stretch. Up next, you want to hear something ridiculous? With another multi-goal game on Tuesday, Tage Thompson is on pace for 65 goals this season. We'll have the highlights when we come back. Welcome back to On the Fly. Now let's get you out to Detroit for the Canes and the Red Wings.
Hockey Town once more for forward David Perron and his 1,000 career National Hockey League games and many more.
Backhanded in front, knocked down, still loose. Rubelik gets to it, but it doesn't get out. That shot deflected. Big stop. Oh, what a save by Husso. Off that initial shot from Chatfield.
Now this didn't end up in the net. It looks like you can thank Kate Wallman. Wow, for picking up Paul Stastny at the side of the net. Net is wide open. There's a deflection in front. And Stastny right jams it right into the toe. Was a dodged bullet for sure for Detroit early in this game.
Gokiniemi back to Pesci. 35 seconds left on the man advantage. Gokiniemi side of the net. Jarvis back at Pesci. Score! Brady Shea. Oh, tic-tac-toe. Brady Shea buries it on the power play.
You got to beat two things, a net front and then an outlet for set plays on the goal line. Turns, he knows it's a set play, and Brady's jumping. And Brady beats Husso to the glove side. Kokiniemi gets his second point in as many games, and we're still in the first period. But just an exceptional play on the goal line.
And chance for Lucas Raymond. He'll throw one on Kochetkov. Kicks it away with a purpose. He kept in by Sherratt. His drive right on save. Kochetkov rebound. Oh, mercy, Piotr Kochetkov with a huge save. Excellent chance for Detroit. And Kochetkov's there again as Jarnik is robbed.
Loses his stick on the outside of the post. Desperation on the glove side, sprawling, then made a really good low save without his stick.
Carolina trying to get it right back. Instead, it's intercepted by Detroit. Larkin with it. Larkin circling the net, sends it out in front. Kochetkov makes a save. Rebound still available. Another save by Kochetkov.
Burns is going to be guilty of the penalty in the process. I don't know. I mean, I know Carolina hasn't been shorthanded, but does his stick ever come parallel? That's a battle. I mean, that stick was vertical, not parallel the entire time. I think that's a very tough break for Brent Burns and the Carolina Hurricanes.
A chop shot from the boards goes wide. 3 seconds left. 2 seconds left. Stastny gets it out, and the Canes will win. And another shutout for Piotr Kochetkov. Two consecutive shutouts for the Canes. Two consecutive shutouts for Kochetkov. And Carolina goes 5-0-1 on this six-game road trip.
Well, I guess the Red Wings just couldn't stand the weather as the Canes came out of Detroit with a 1-0 victory, their 12th road win. Brady Shea scored the lone goal, extending his point streak to 4 games. And Piotr Kochetkov made 27 saves and now has back-to-back shutouts, bringing his season total to 3, which is tied for the NHL lead. Now off to Sunrise for the Blue Jackets and the Panthers.
Lostarinen gets to it, carries behind the net, tries to center, jabbed out in front. By Bennett.
They like to play below the goal line, and this is a hallmark of their team. So if you're a goaltender, if you're a defender of Columbus, you got to make sure you're picking guys up in front of the net because they like these plays. They like to get behind the net. They like to grind. They want to get it out front.
Into the right wing corner. They'll get it back out to the blue line. Across to Brandon Montour with a shot. He scores. Montour had to stop that puck, settle it down at the top of the left wing circle, and he blasted by Elvis Merzlikins.
And the Panthers strike first here at home.
They want to play behind the net, but they also have a group of defense that are willing to chip in offensively, and you give them time and space, and they're not afraid to shoot pucks.
Lugged into the zone. Reinhardt on the wing toward the center, and they score. Reinhardt's delivery leads to a Kachuk goal, and it's 2-0 Panthers here in the second.
Watch the way Reinhardt comes in, second effort from Barkov to point that forward, and then they're on the rush, and watch Kachuk going to the spot and then stopping up in a shooting position. Reinhardt eyes up the whole way, but instead of continuing towards the net, Kachuk stops and readies for the shot.
Rally goes to retrieve his stick. Shot from the sharp angle there, almost snuck in behind Merzlikins and kicked out.
I thought initially it went in.
A whistle stop play. Montour took a shot, and the Blue Jackets didn't like that.
I thought initially that this puck did go in the net. I mean, I could be totally wrong, but Boy, it was a weird looking play.
Let's take a second look. And it goes off the back pad of Merzlikins and stays out.
Wow.
That is a close call.
After video review, there is no goal on the play. The puck did not cross the goal line.
Reinhart gets it over to Tkachuk. Forsling steps into one. Kicked aside by Gavrikov. They score! It's Barkov! And late in the second, it's a three-goal lead for Florida. A Barkov, and that's a sharp angle and a great finish from Barkov. You keep an eye on him in front. There's the work down low. And there's Barkov from a sharp angle, backhand, forehand in the net. Made it look a lot easier than it was. 6-on-5, extra skater is on.
And selfish play by Tkachuk trying to get Reinhart at the goal, but an even better play by Bjork.
Now off the takeaway, they score. Reinhart from the blue line to put it on ice for the Panthers. Here come the Rats, and that's a 4-0 Panthers win over Columbus. And Sergei Bobrovsky, after 7 seasons in Columbus, has his first career shutout against the Jackets.
Panthers get their second shutout win of the season thanks to Sergei Bobrovsky's 22-save performance. Sam Reinhart notches his first three-point night with a goal and two helpers. And Matthew Tkachuk now has scored a goal in 8 straight contests against the Blue Jackets. Now let's check out the Kings and the Sabres in Buffalo.
With Thompson, top line off for Buffalo. Dolly the front, loose puck, top denied. Point blank, first save of the night for Phoenix. Copley, and it's a beauty.
Well, the Kings were dominant. Look at this, right in the crease. Copley was able to sense the cross pass and just wait. And then all of a sudden, reflexes come out with a left leg pad to make the save right there.
With Dahlin, supporting Dahlin takes the overlap. There's the lane. Dahlin walks in and fires, and Copley makes the save. After the Kings again continue to put pressure on, and this game continues to have an attitude to it.
Does his thing, steps in, there's a quick shot. Copley makes the save, then a little bump after by Alafao.
You got your star player being picked on. Usually don't you had to go pick on one of your own on the other side. And
yeah, it's usually the best way to do it, either go score a goal or go pick on somebody of equal caliber on the other side, and then go talk to him, make it hard on him, lean on him a little bit.
Of the LA net, here's a chance, scores right off the draw, and it's TNT lets it rip, and finally one pays off to open the scoring in this game.
Tage Thompson's going to get his 22nd of the year here.
The shot is lethal, it's unbelievable.
Here's a chance, in front, scores! Victor Olofsson, good work down low, and Olofsson found the soft spot, Razor, and sat on it, parked it.
Olofsson wide open to the front, that quick pass that comes from the corner.
Paterka for Quinn, back to Paterka, score! The fun line makes it look fun right there, and it's a 3-0 Sabres lead.
This is what you want to see. J.J. Paterka puts it into the net for the third goal here.
Rebound came to the feet, and there's a ball from Alex Tuck way in the slot, and a big smile as he goes to the bench.
Nice job here by the Sabres, just moving the puck around. Really getting LA a lot of movement there, but they didn't hesitate to take shots, and I think that was the big thing.
It's time Cousins just over the line. Thompson, far circle, breaks the back of the net with that one practically as he lets it rip. Second of the game, another power play goal for the Sabres.
Another perfect pass by Dahlin. He just slides it right across, and he just makes contact with it. He's got so much torque in that stick that it's just amazing.
Victor Olofsson, backhand towards the net, thinking about it, scores! Peyton Krebs! Putting the work in tonight. Paying off in this third period, 6-0 Buffalo.
And this is what you want to see from Peyton Krebs. A little bounce in front there. He just gets himself in that dirty area right there. Once he realizes Olsen's going to take this puck to the net, he gets himself up on top of that blue paint, the feed right there. Nice vision there by Olsen as well to find Krebs, but that's what you want to see right there. He does a nice job of finding it.
The Sabres earned their first shutout win of the season thanks to Craig Anderson's 40-save night. Now, Buffalo's 6-goal third period was the second time they've scored as many in a single frame this season. And what's a Buffalo scoring surge without Tage Thompson? Well, he scored twice and is now on pace for a whopping 65 goals this season. Still to come, the Avalanche are banged up, but certainly the defending Stanley Cup champs wouldn't get swept by the Flyers, or would they? Find out when On the Fly returns.
game with points.
Here's one, it's in, it's gone! What a goal by Brydon Point!
Cue the highlight reel, that will be shown for weeks.
Thompson, far circle, breaks the back of the net with that one practically as he lets it rip. His second of the game. Leon Draisaitl scorching against the Preds.
Mastinac has a chance to put the Bruins in the driver's seat.
Oh, he scores! Torture chamber!
Jonathan Marchessault on the power play, and the Golden Knights lead 5-4.
They score, and it's Alex Ovechkin, and it's 800 goals! Third player in National Hockey League history to score 800 goals!
Well, it was a night of many milestones for the great eight on Tuesday, and he wasted no time, scoring 24 seconds into the win against the Hawks. Now, on top of reaching 800 goals, he has now surpassed Jaromir Jagr for the most game-opening goals in NHL history with 136. Now, let's get you back to the highlights with the Flyers and the Avs.
So this power play, second ranked, but slumping of late, goes to work. Nichushkin allowed to walk right to the side. That gets it back to the point for the shot. By Makar and the save by Sandstrom.
Well, do you see Lekkonen and watch him slide down the backside here? It's a great play, so it's going to go down low to Nichushkin. Now watch Comfort go on the far side. He's looking. Then he tries to go high to Comfort. Can't find him. Well, may as well hit Cale Makar.
Nice move by Cam York to get free here. His shot, save, rebound. They score! York follows up his own shot, tips it home. And the Flyers take a 1-0 lead as York continues to impress.
Watch a little spin play. Watch how agile he is here. Look at that. Right around the forward, shot to the net, and then tracks it to the net. And on the backhand, skillfully lifts it up and over Francois. An outstanding individual effort. Some good help from JVR in front again. Screening the netminder, keeping the play alive.
Contact was outside of the blue paint, so therefore we have a goal.
All right, they confirm it.
The ref was waving it off, and almost immediately, as you watch JVR where he is positioned, and that's the ice that JVR is allowed to skate in.
Here comes JT, gives it down the slot, score! Devon Taves able to tip it right past Sandstrom. He may have found the five hole, and Riker, you ask, Footer, you ask, and you both shall receive. Yeah, the Avs have tied the game at one. Finally does as Frost has collapsed the puck right inside the line. And it's set up and out by Eric Johnson. Smart play. Watch out. Here's Lekkonen and shoots and scores. Arturi Lekkonen. A short-handed goal. The fourth of the year for the Colorado Avalanche. For Lekkonen. That's his eighth goal of the season. Welcome back to the lineup 62. You gotta love the Avs. They were so aggressive. They don't respect Philly's power play. They're aggressive on their line. They did it three times and it paid off. Jammed away there by Tippett. Puck comes to Comfort. He shoots and scores. JT Comfort got the perfect feed and he rips it top shelf past Sandstrom. The Avs have the 3-1 lead for JT Comfort. His fourth of the season. He continues to impress as the Avs go up by two.
York to Hayes. To connect, he scores! In front was Van Riemsdyk. May have gotten a piece of it, and the Flyers are within one. Don't go anywhere. 3-2 with 3:38 to play.
JT again can't win the draw. Sent on the drive, save by Francois, and that will do it. It came down to the very end. But the Avs, even up the season series against the Philadelphia Flyers tonight, they start off the homestand in style. As they beat Philly by a final score of 3-2.
Now to the Coyotes and the Sharks.
Tonight marks the 2000th regular season Sharks television broadcast. For play-by-play announcer, Randy Hahn. We congratulate Randy on this remarkable achievement.
Well, both these teams have a long, rich tradition against one another, and they're both coming off victories. Back for Harrington and now Šimek. He'll fire and score! Rodim Šimek, and it's 1-0 Sharks.
It's a beautifully tipped
puck by Tomas Hertl to get the goal.
And for Tomas Hertl, that'll be goal number 10 on the year as he gets to double digits, and the Sharks have the lead here in the first period. Back to the line again, and they score again off the rebound. It's Bonino, and it's 2-0.
Well, when Nick Bonino starts the heat up, he really heats up. Four goals now in his last four games. Another quick shot by the Sharks. And just like this, the hot stick continues to stay hot for Bonino.
The Coyotes are going to have a lot of meat in a five-on-three power play.
Side of the net. Krause, he scores. He turned to the front, and he gets a power play goal.
That is the velvet, partner, that I keep talking about. We've seen the hammer from Lawson Krause. That is the velvet top shelf far side, and that is a team leading 13th of the year.
Well, Sharks are picking up where they left off early in that first period. Here's Harrington, and the Melka push hard across, rebound, score! Nico Sturm, right on cue. Sharks make it 3-1.
Well, Scott Harrington, for me, is playing some good hockey since being recalled. This quick shot sets up this goal, and Sturm cashes in.
Harrington still battling on the near boards against big Lawson Krause. Pacelli went down. Krause's shot. Reimer the save, rebound. He stopped that, too, and he's got his glove over it. James Reimer responds with two solid stops here mid-game.
Coyotes would love to get tied with the San Jose Sharks, but they got to battle back here. Nemeth to the front, rebound, and they score! Bjugstad on the doorstep. Reimer coughs up a rebound, and guess what? It's a one-goal game again.
Wow, there's that alligator blood. The Arizona Coyotes hanging around this one, and Reimer not happy.
Their net's empty. Extra man on. Krause sends it across. Final seconds. Chychrun shoots, blocked in front, and that'll do it. And the Sharks hang on and win. In his return to the lineup, James Reimer will get the victory.
Time now for your top shelf plays of the night.
Held by Timmons.
Feeds ahead. It's Kevin Marner. Pulls. Back to score. Tavares. And the streak goes on. Mitch Marner. 23 consecutive games.
Late. It's 2-on-1. Look out. Here it comes to Glendinning. In deep. Schmid the save. He stops the rebound as well. Another otherworldly save from Akira Schmid.
Yeah, was able to collect that pass. Point on the middle. Here's Point.
You get a puck on your stick, you look up, you want to make a play sometimes.
McDavid scores coast to coast. League leading 26.
And now they score, and it's Alex Ovechkin. 798, that is 799. It's 800 goals in the National Hockey League. Alex Ovechkin, 800 goals.
Time now for your three stars of the night. Jake DeBrusque is our third star as he scored two goals to help Boston extend their home point streak to 16 games. Zach Hyman gets the second star after netting his first career hattie. And Ovi's hattie put him in the 800 club, which makes him our first star. Hopefully you haven't gotten your fill of Mitch Marner yet, because the Leafs are bringing you the bobblehead version of Toronto's stud while wearing the reverse retros. Now here's the catch. This is limited edition. And by limited, we mean 72 total for sale at the bargain price of $75. But I'm guessing by the time you see this, they're already gone. So enjoy this picture. Well, that does it for this edition of On the Fly. For our great crew here at NHL Network, I'm LG Red. See you next time.
Mitch Marner, 23 consecutive games.
Oh, he scores!
What a win.
Zach Hyman, his first career hat trick.
What a goal by Brayden Point.
Cue the highlight reel.
Another otherworldly save from Akira Schmid.
And it's TNT, lets it rip.
The shot is lethal.